All right, part two. Tim Ostendorf discussing the rest of Joan Sutherland singing the big Act Four aria. You know, I slammed my hand down and it hit my mouse and it paused the video. So all that, I ain't redoing that video. This is gonna be part two. So I was just about to say this Da Mor Sulare Arose thing, and she, I played some versions where at the end the dite scordarmi, it keeps going up to an A flat, and then the last time Joan Sutherland sings a high C, and on the Rosalind Plowright recording she just does it as written, just keep it going up to that A flat, and then Leontine Price, when she does the repeat, she sings the high C twice, which to me kind of ruins it. And I was likening that to a friend of mine that sang on one of my opera dinners at the Inn at Crystal Lake. Yes, Tim Ostendorf here, Inn at Crystal Lake. So if you're not watching this video after the other one, you're going to be like, what the heck is he talking about? But anyway, watch the other one and then watch this one, okay? And she sang I Can Cook Too from Bernstein's On the Town. And she sings I Can Cook Too, I Can Even Hit a High C. And then she sings it again, she can even hit a high C. Well, both times she actually sang the high C, but I thought it would have been better if she did it the second time, similar to this Joan Sutherland recording. By just doing it the last time, you think, is she going to do it? Is she not going to do it? And then she does it, and it's glorious. And then we will go into the Tour de Fred Dry and wrap up this two-part video. Those low notes. Okay, now it ends, right? Well, they do this very strange modulation so that she can sing a big high note at the end of the cavaletta. And it sounds, when you're looking at the score, it sounds really weird. You may not think it's that weird until you're actually looking at the score, if you're really familiar with it, and you're like, what the heck is she singing? To do this scene without this cavaletta makes no sense to me. And I mean, it's a very traditional, it's got the little recitative and then it goes into the slow aria and then it's got that wonderful chorus in the middle and then it to go into the cavaletta. How can you not do the cavaletta? It doesn't make any sense to me at all. Thank you. can you not do this? I mean, you've got those runs in there, but it shouldn't be that difficult. You get some staccato high notes, and if you do it in the key and not higher like she's doing it, what's the big deal? But Ava Martone, I'm sure she does not do the Cappelletta in that, horrible video from the Met with Pavarotti, it's a disaster, sorry. I actually really like the Sandra Radovansky, what's her name? Telecast, was it last year? It was very dark, people thought it was too dark, but it was on this revolving stage and it made the action move very smoothly. I really enjoyed it personally. And just a few ornaments, nothing too crazy. You know, and she takes out the last few notes, and then and I guess if you can do it like that, most sopranos can't, so maybe that's why they don't do it, right? So anyway, sorry that the video had to be in two pieces. I got so rambunctious, so I slapped down my hand and hit my little mousy-pousy, but Jinx and I are happy to have you back. There you are. Hello, Jinx. Jinx Monsoon, winner of last season's RuPaul's Drag Race. But the new one, Bianca Del Rio, is wonderful as well. She can cut a bitch. Am I supposed to say that on YouTube? I don't know. Anyway, Tim Ostendorf here, innkeeper and baritone and bartender, maker of wonderful Manhattans. But tonight, that's right, I got my kickstart. Woohoo! All things Joan Sutherland, and that really wore me out. I gotta go take a nap. Thank you for joining me, and keep watching my videos on the YouTubes, and we'll see you soon. Have a good night. Happy spring. Happy Memorial Day. Happy Memorial Day. It is Memorial Day. Happy Memorial Day and all that means. Thanks for watching. Okay,